With Google AdWords analyzing your data and building out new campaigns to improve on what's working is critical for getting success in keeping your conversions lower. So I showed you the basic two campaigns I built on Rob's ad accounts here, and you can see all of the data now. What we've been working to do is slowly scale this up. The problem is if you simply increase the budget, then the average cost per click's going to go up too. What you want ideally is smaller budget campaigns that are functioning exceptionally well. And you can do that through good data analysis. So one thing Robert wanted to do was target areas specifically where there are regions banks. So I made a campaign in just areas and cities with regions banks, and I just copied the buy Bitcoin campaign and then targeted it by city instead of targeting it to all US. But here's what the data shows. The data shows even though this ad is showing an average position of 1.8, even though the ad's showing higher, the cost per conversion is way more. So that's all time, but look at this now. On the last 7 days, it's even worse. So there's been 6 conversions total. This campaign needs to be paused. Now you can also go after one-time opportunities, and Bitstamp went down, so I made a campaign for Rob for Bitstamp. This didn't work at all. You can see the importance of conversion tracking, because absent of conversion tracking, the cost per click, the click-through rate, all start to become important along with the average position. But if you don't get actual conversions, it's meaningless. So look at the Bitstamp one, for example. The clicks were expensive, the position was high, and no conversions. Well, the Bitcoin display one got a lot of clicks at a low cost per click, no conversions. The Bitcoin regions got decent cost per click, a very high position, and more expensive conversions. So what we want to do now is figure out what is working the best and how can we zoom in on that. How can we do more of what's working really well? So what we want to look at on this campaign is where is the actual ad spend going? So the ad spend is going into both the display network and the search network on this. And the challenge with that is the display network has never converted once. The Google Display Network shows in places like Gmail and on AdSense websites. This campaign has spent $57 on the Google Display Network, 0 conversions. This often happens on Google, especially if you have a very niche product or service. The Display Network may not work at all for it, and that's why it's critical to isolate the Display Network and Search Network, especially in the reporting. So the simple solution for this might be to just turn this ad set off and try and expand on it. However, Rob is getting conversions out of this campaign for under $10 each and $7.54 out of the search. So it's not necessarily something that should just be turned off because it is working pretty well. What we want to find is what is actually working the best. So on the Bitcoin keyword, those conversions are coming out for $7.31, and then Bitcoins are coming out more expensive. So it looks like people searching for Bitcoin generally are more likely to be converting. Now here's the thing. Given this campaign in the last few weeks has only produced 4 conversions at an average of $14 each, compared to the other one, this one might just be worth pausing. Even though the cost per conversion over time's been pretty good, it's not producing at the same level the other one is. So this is enough data. The conversions are costing 50% more in this campaign. But the challenge is this campaign's also accounted for 25 of the conversions. So to continue analyzing before pausing the other one, let's take a look at this one. You can see this has no display network in it at all. And here's the keywords. So the keywords in this that are working best are Bitcoin Cash. When people are searching for Bitcoin Cash, there's a 1% conversion rate. That's sick. That is amazing. And the cost per conversion is only $3.14 then. Let's look at the last 7 days. And you'll see it actually goes down to $2 as Google has figured out how good this is working too. The ad position's way higher. So it looks like what I want to do is make a new campaign with just Bitcoin Cash and pause the other ones. So what I am going to do for this campaign to help it run a little better. Now Google is already trying to get the most conversions, but it's still showing ads on these other keywords. If you look the last 7 days, Google is still trying these other keywords to see if it can get a conversion. But you want to do enough data so that you've got good results on it. So looking at all time, 300 and some odd impressions on these, thousands on here, no conversions, all these might as well be paused in this campaign. And interestingly, the Buy Bitcoin Cash has not worked good at all with only 6 clicks and no conversions. It's strange that the Buy Bitcoin Cash did not work, but the just Bitcoin Cash keyword does work. Now looking at these then, you have Get Bitcoin, Get Bitcoins, Bitcoin Cash, and Buy Bitcoin. These have actually got some conversions, but the conversion rate's a lot lower, and it appears that this campaign would be best to just focus on these terms that are working better. The trick is Buy Bitcoin is still working really well in this campaign. Now let's check the last maybe even 14 days and see what we're looking at. So Get Bitcoin hasn't done anything in the last 14 days. Now Get Bitcoins has done pretty well in the last 14 days with 4 conversions at 591. So it's worth looking at all of these different breakdowns of the data to try and see, okay, so how is this actually working out? Over the last 30 days, Get Bitcoins is not doing as good. So what I'm going to do is just pause Get Bitcoin and leave these other 3 running. Since they are working, I don't necessarily want to turn them off, but what I can do is just create a separate ad set to scale this out. So I can create another ad group here, or I can make an entirely new campaign to add to what I'm already doing. So that will be the next step, is to use this data analysis I've went through right here with you. Use this data analysis to show what to do next. So I've just turned off a significant portion of the ads, and based on the data, I'm going to turn this campaign off altogether because the cost per conversion is higher on it, and I want to be able to focus all of Rob's budget through what is working the best. And I'm going to do that in creating this next group of campaigns. One final point is to take a look at the keyword scores. So the keyword scores help give you an idea of how good Google thinks the keywords are. So you note that this Buy Bitcoin is 5 out of 10, but the Bitcoin Cash comes up as 7 out of 10, and the Get Bitcoins comes up as 7 out of 10. And some of these keywords that didn't work had lower keyword scores, but overall the keyword scores are all decent. What you want to do to get the lowest rate is to be running ads through the highest keyword scores all the time. So I appreciate you watching this. I hope this Google AdWords tutorial for analyzing campaigns has been helpful for you. And what I'm going to do next now is show how I use this to create more ads and scale up what is working.